CNN is learning that law enforcement may have thwarted as many as three possible mass shootings in the last 5 days. In Florida, an arrest caught on camera of a man who sheriff's deputies say was fascinated with mass shootings. According to investigators, the man detailed plans to, quote, shoot as many people as he could in a large crowd. Police reportedly hailing that man's ex-girlfriend as a hero, saying she tipped them off. And in Connecticut, the FBI arrested another man in his 20s after receiving a tip that he was attempting to purchase large-capacity rifle magazines from out of state. Upon raiding his home, authorities say they found a stockpile of illegal weapons, including rifles, a handgun, and titanium body armor. And in Ohio, the FBI seized an arsenal of weapons from a 20-year-old man they say threatened to attack a Jewish community center. Police say that man, a 20-year-old, is a self-professed white nationalist who had racist and anti-Semitic posts on his social media. CNN's Pola Sandoval is following all of these developments. So, Pola, what more can you tell us?
Well, first, we should note that that Ohio man's name is James Reardon. Police say he made an Instagram post of a video which shows a man shooting a rifle. But one of the things that really caught the attention of police in New Middletown, Ohio, is that the Jewish Community Center in Youngstown was actually tagged in that caption. And that caption also implies that the gunman that's seen in the video would be the shooter behind a potential attack at the center. We should also note that that Instagram page also includes many anti-Semitic comments and white nationalist content. Now, before charging Reardon with telecommunications harassment, police did recover several rifles in his mother's home, ammunition, a gas mask, a bayonet. All of it's being processed at this hour. The FBI has interviewed Reardon, but at this point, they have not pressed any federal charges of their own. So at this point, those charges remain at the state level. The Youngstown Area Jewish Federation, which actually runs the Jewish Community Center, saying that not only it, but also other various synagogues in the area are currently seeing additional security there. I also want to take you to Florida for the second case that we're monitoring, in where police body camera video actually shows the arrest of 25-year-old man who's believed to have threatened to commit a mass shooting. That 25-year-old's name is Tristan Wicks of Daytona Beach. He was detained by police. He's suspected of sending text messages that were threatening to open fire on large crowds. In fact, one of them specifically read, quote, "A school is a weak target. I'd be more likely to open fire on a large crowd of people from over 3 miles away. I'd want to break a world record for longest confirmed kill ever." Again, that's a post there. According to a release from the county sheriff's office, Wicks told detectives that he does not actually own weapons. However, he is fascinated with mass shootings, Fred.
And then in Connecticut, what are we learning?
That's a third case that we know about, where a Connecticut man was arrested on Thursday who also showed an interest in carrying out a mass shooting. Police say 22-year-old Brandon Wagshaw was arrested on weapons charges in Norwalk, Connecticut. Police saying that they received a tip that he was buying a rifle, or at least various rifle parts, and then attempted to build his own weapon. But also in this case, what caught the attention of police were various Facebook posts that indicated that he wanted to carry out a mass shooting. He remains in custody. So really the main attention here that's being focused on of all these three different investigations are these various posts that were put online. That's what initially caught the attention of federal investigators, and also in many cases, of course, local police as well.
Mm-hmm. All right, Pola Sandoval, thank you so much. All right, so for more now on the Florida arrest, I'm joined on the phone by Volusia County Sheriff Michael Chitwood. So, Sheriff, take me through how your office was alerted about these shocking text messages.
Yeah, the girlfriend is a real hero here. She went to a local municipality, showed the text messages, and actually four municipalities got involved before Daytona Beach Shores, which you see there in the body camera video, they make the arrest. And then the sheriff's office, we get involved, we start debriefing him, we read the text messages, we get a search warrant, we go to his apartment, we recover a .22 rifle and 400 rounds of ammunition. Clearly, when you look at this kid's background, he is the profile of a shooter. He's 24 years old. He lost his job. He lost his girlfriend. He's depressed. He's got the ammunition, and he wants to become known for being the most prolific killer in American history. He even says in one of his text messages where he talks about it would be good, a good way to die happy is killing other people.
Mm. And you made the discovery of those weapons after you pursued him over the alarming text. So now this young man is in custody. He is being interviewed or has been interviewed. What more has he been willing to say? What's his story? What have you learned?
He hasn't given up his location to us yet, but it's concerning because he's clearly outside of the realm of society, of normal society. So we're going to be interested to see what his fingerprints and his DNA come back to. He's being held without bond. And in Florida, we have what's called risk protection orders where we seize your firearms. You're unable to purchase or obtain firearms until he's pending a hearing with a judge. So, you know, this is what they are. They fly below the radar screen, these folks. And it's so important for the community to notify law enforcement. All three cases that you see, it's people coming forward and prevented mass killings over the weekend, I believe.
Yeah, that vigilance was something else. I mean, that's very powerful. Now, you made reference to, you know, we haven't pinpointed his location. What do you mean by that, his location? You mean his state of mind?
No, his location of where he intended to carry this out. I mean, we're like Volusia County, Florida, and Daytona Beach. We're like every other city and county in America. You know, we have festivals and events, and you know, would be a target-rich environment.
Right, because and so now I'm reviewing some of his texts. You're talking about, like, he made a specific reference in his text where he says, "But a good 100 kills would be nice. I already have a location.
Correct.
Is that bad?"
That's what we're thinking. Yeah, I mean, he already knows in his mind what his plan was. And like I said, he had a rifle and 400 rounds of ammunition. There's a lot of carnage could have been caused when he fulfilled what I truly believe in my heart that he is an active shooter. That's exactly what he was. He fits the profile exactly.
Wow. So reports are that it was roughly 12 hours from when deputies, you know, first got the tip from this ex-girlfriend. You know, between that information and his arrest. I mean, you were able to move rather quickly because, you know, most people might presume investigating an individual might take a lot longer than that before acting on that kind of tip.
Yeah, but in this case, it was all the municipalities worked together. You know, in the first municipality got the initial information. It wasn't their jurisdiction. They passed it on to the second municipality, who went to his place of work, discovered he was fired. The third municipality was Daytona Beach Shores, who was able to set up a surveillance and get him outside of the Winn-Dixie. And then the sheriff's office, we got involved, started questioning him, got the search warrant, seized his weapons, did the risk protection order. So it was all of law enforcement in Volusia County saying, hey, this is a serious threat. We got to get our hands on him, and we got to recover any firearms and ammunition that he has.
Sheriff Michael Chitwood, thank you so much for your time in Volusia County. Appreciate it.